Hello, everyone, and welcome to theCUBE's Tech Innovation CUBED Awards. I'm your host, Rebecca Knight, and we are celebrating the winners of our inaugural program that showcases the incredible ingenuity and creativity taking place across the tech landscape. Today, we are joined by Poornima DeBolle. She is the co-founder and chief product officer at Menlo Security and the award winner for our Innovative Women in Tech Leadership. Thank you so much. Congratulations, Poornima. Thank you for coming on the show.
Yeah, thank you for having me. And I'm very excited about this award. Thank you for the award in the first place. And hopefully, you know, this is helpful and a good launch for a lot more women on a go-forward basis.
So before we get started, I want to let our viewers know that this honors outstanding women in the B2B tech industry who have made remarkable contributions through exceptional technical innovation or visionary organizational leadership. And Poornima, this is not the first time you've been honored this way. You were named one of Inc's top female founders. You were on a Forbes top 50 list, many others. You've had an incredible career so far. Looking back, what do you think really has been your secret sauce of innovation and leadership when you think about your career?
Oh, wow.
A big question to get going.
Yes. let's get into it at the top. I've been doing this for a long time. So obviously, you know, 20 plus years of doing this, there's a lot to think about. But I think maybe from a success or kind of ongoing willingness to hang in there, ability, right? I just love tech. It's just, you know, I'm very fortunate. When I started engineering school, I was originally in mechanical engineering. And I decided that, you know, all of the dust in the workshop and things like that were not to my liking. And computer science was one where you would be in a air-conditioned room for most of your workday. And I was like, all right, this sounds good, so sign me up. But I remember going into my second year of engineering and getting to know the insides of the computer. I went to engineering school for my undergraduate in India. And there, we do something called computer engineering, not so much just software, but you have to know the full system. And I remember writing my first, you know, digital whatever lab program to make an elevator go up and down on a board. And I was just the logic of it, the technology, the understanding. And I just count myself to be very fortunate, like how nicely it clicked into my brain. And I've never looked back, right? I know we all say it, and I'm sure there's orders of truth to saying we love what we do, but I truly do love what I do. And that's been kind of maybe the fuel and kind of the basis for any success, modicum of success I've had.
Tell our viewers a little bit about Menlo Security. And we've heard about the sparks you had early in your career as an undergraduate student and graduate student. Tell our viewers a little bit about where you are today and your company.
Yeah, so Menlo Security is about a 10-year-old company. And as co-founder, I've been here from day zero and looked at office spaces and bought water for the company and all of those things you do as a founder. But from a company perspective, I'm truly very proud of where we are with Menlo Security. We pioneered what's called cloud browsing, right? There's a variety of names for it. I think the current name is called a secure cloud browser. And the idea starts from when we started thinking about Menlo. The thought was rather than deliver security based on something you know, right? So I know this file is bad, I can block it. I know this domain is bad, I can block it, which all relies on prior knowledge for you to do something, to know something. We looked at the problem space and we said, how can we make something architecturally secure, right? So you as the user, be it Rebecca yourself or anybody even in your family, when you're interacting with the broader internet, you don't really know what's happening on the back end, but you're secure by architecture. That was kind of the genesis of our idea. And I'm very proud that, you know, 10 years later, we count some of the largest financials, the U.S. Department of Defense as our customers, and we've kind of delivered that vision into reality for millions of users and protect them as they kind of browse the internet on a regular basis from very sophisticated attacks because we have that secure by architecture design.
So you've played a pivotal role in conceptualizing and implementing so many of Menlo's products. I want you to think just broadly, when you think about this era of digital transformation and the B2B tech world, which is witnessing tremendous shifts right now, what is your vision for the future of B2B tech? And how are you positioning Menlo Security to drive innovation?
Yeah, so it's a great question. And the B2B tech, like you said, is undergoing huge transformation, right? One of the things that we see in terms of great transformation is when people went home for COVID, right? All of a sudden, we had this giant population which used to go to work every day, now needing to be enabled for remote work, hybrid work, you know, variety of words that we use to describe that scenario. And when it came to that, one of the biggest things people needed to do is like, how do I give access to all of these things that you use, right? Applications on a regular basis that you used to use from the office, how do I give you secure access to that? So to your point about innovation, we were really, really well positioned with the architecture that we had built to then say, I can not only protect you when you go to the internet, but I can use that same platform to give you both access and security to be it SaaS applications or be it your own enterprise application. So our ability to kind of take that secure by architecture and almost turn it around 180 degrees and say, now you can connect to your applications in a safe way. And in that case, we're actually protecting your application from your user's endpoint. Now, that also, from a B2B perspective, has enabled more innovation and transformation for our customers, because now that you have the ability to protect your application with the same architecture, you can also start looking at cost optimizations with bring your own device or contractors and things like that. So from an innovation perspective, COVID was hard for all of us, but it also gave us this unique perspective and kind of a lead into using and expanding our platform in a way that we add more value to our customers than in a productivity sector and a security sector. So kind of widened our aperture on how we engage with our customers.
Well, I want to actually piggyback a little bit on that, because your mantra is, if you're going to do something, do it well. And now I might embarrass you a little bit by reading what your colleague wrote about you in her nomination of you. She said, Poornima has an unwavering commitment to comprehending customer problems. She listens attentively, seeking to grasp the causes and the motivations behind their concerns. It's this empathetic approach that has contributed to Menlo's success. But can you talk a little bit about this approach and the role that empathy plays in business and technology, particularly today? I mean, you mentioned the pandemic. That's just one example. But how do you think about your leadership style and your empathetic approach in terms of bringing you success?
Oh, wow. That was a really sweet comment. And I'm glad it gets noticed. You know, don't think of it on a daily basis, obviously. So I think I maybe give you one example of an incident where early on in my engineering life, you think like an engineer, right? Like you're problem solving for the problem in front of you. And I recall my first job out of college, my then CEO took me to Stanford, who was one of our customers. And then I had this unique recognition of like everything I think about when I'm building it in the lab, there is a whole host of them that doesn't even translate when they deploy it in the real world. So it was a transformative experience for me. And from then on, I've always channeled the fact that whatever you build needs to solve a problem for a customer. And a lot of times, you know, as engineers, product people are very proud of what we've built, and we go down the path of, let me tell you about all the bells and whistles and
things. I know some engineers, so I know.
Yeah, you know that.
Relatable.
Well, yes. But every time we've listened, and I'm very proud at Menlo, where we call them design partners. Some of our largest customers have been our design partners. And the minute we engage with them on trying to understand the why of what they're trying to do something, they like come to us and it's like, oh, I don't like this feature. This doesn't work. And then rather than try to explain to them why it does work, I always take the perspective of, tell me, what are you trying to solve? Like, why does this not work? And I can confidently say that any product manager or any product person who can channel that empathy is going to be very successful, right? Because you're solving problems and your customers appreciate, even if you can't solve it that day, the fact that you're willing to listen and come back to them with solutions that solves their problem. So yeah, it's one.
Acknowledge what they're going through.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And at Menlo, we buy a lot of software products, right, to run our company. And I appreciate that with my own vendors, right? So it's universally, like you said, same thing, we live as humans, but to be able to translate that into our professional lives goes a long way.
So last question, I don't need to tell you about the dearth of women in STEM and technology. You know this all too well. When you think about the challenges you've experienced, obstacles you've overcome, growing up in India and then coming to the US, being a woman of color founder in male-dominated Silicon Valley, do you have advice or words of wisdom for the younger women who are perhaps just starting their careers watching this, who aspire to having a career in cybersecurity like you?
Yeah. I mean, I think it's, you know, sometimes when you're younger, you quite don't have the appreciation of the picture that you just painted, right? Like, you're doing your thing. But as I have kind of engaged with both the C-suite, be it our own company, VCs and things like that, I can assure you that that has been painfully obvious in the recent years of my experience. And I think the biggest point that I make, I have a daughter who's also in engineering, different field. The point that I make to all young women out there is, be confident, right? Whenever you're at the table, you're there because you earned your spot. You're not there to listen. Be active. Don't be subject to the imposter syndrome. You know, don't feel like I don't have a place. So that unique ability to understand that you're there for a reason and be able to engage and participate is probably one of the biggest way that you can win in this field. The second thing that I also tell, to your point about male-dominated, is I think it's male-dominated for a variety of reasons that came before us, right? So the best way you today can engage that is with the problem-solving mindset and find your male allies, right? Like, even the males who are in the positions of power today, a lot of times don't even realize or recognize what's going on. I give a lot of credit to my boss, you know, our CEO that I worked with for like 25 years now. I also give a lot of credit to my husband, who is also kind of helps me understand and navigate things. So rather than think of it as a disadvantage that you are at, turn that into a problem solving, you know, thought process and say, here are all these, you know, male colleagues you have. How do I find a mentor? How do I find an ally? In kind of breaking the barriers from that perspective is much more productive than making it an us versus them, right?
Finding your teammates. I love it. Great advice, Poornima. Congratulations again on this award. Well-deserved.
Thank you, Rebecca. I really appreciate the award and the recognition, and happy to have this conversation with you.
And thank you to our viewers to tuning into this special segment of theCUBE's Tech Innovation Cubed Awards. I'm Rebecca Knight. Stay tuned for more.